On 25th of December 2020 was premiered on Netflix a new romantic drama series called Bridgerton. It's based on Julia Quinn's novels from Regency era, and it's about London stones. And that series, it's created by Chris Van Dusen, and it's produced by I think Shonda Rhimes, and it's just gorgeous. When I clicked on that series, it's on Netflix right now, and it's keeping first position, like the famous or favorite what people watch. And I'm not surprised. When I clicked on it for first time, and I already saw all series four times, all those episodes four times. When I clicked on it first time, I was just, I'm gonna have a look. And I couldn't stop to watch it. It's well made, it's gorgeous, actors are amazing, designs are amazing, music is gorgeous, and all those flowers around, it's just breathtaking. It's gorgeous to watch it, it's very relaxing, and what is the best? At these days, it has happy end. That's why I do love it so much. And I believe I'm not the only one. One of the very important person in that series is Lady Whistledown. It's the secret person who is publishing small booklets with gossips about the London Stone. Inspired by that, because who needs the more journal than a writer? I did my small research and I created my design and then this book with this holder about that that era inspired by Bridgerton. At that time I found that there was a publisher, Chris Whittingham, which is very close to that Whistledown. So I chose his name or the name, the surname, and I created my booklets with his surname and also with the name of the monthly gazette which he print out. It was European magazine, and it had few themes, and one of those themes was London society. There was about medicine, I didn't mean in the London society, was about people in London, but there was also monthly books or magazines about health, about chemistry, about inventions. You know, they had few different types, and one of them was London Society, and I found few columns, beautiful columns. I've got somewhere here the second one. We will get there. So inspired by that, I made my two booklets using Mr. Whittingham's surname and also the name of his books or magazines, and I took few columns, and they're amazing to read. They are really beautiful. So I've got my booklets, and I have created some kind of holder for my book, for that journal, where I can store the things I think if I will be at that time I will wanna keep. So there will be of course letters with that seal stamp, because they do just look amazing. They just look so cute. I wish to receive some letter like this. I think I will love it so much. And I will definitely, as a secret publisher, to keep addresses of, you know, printer companies. There will be some notes, and there will be also the callers. Callers was young lads. Who should show the interest in young ladies, in debutantes, who was presented front of the Queen. And at the time, wasn't yet photography. The photography was invented, this is from 1813, that Bridgerton. And photography, first photography was, I think, 1865. If I'm not mistaken, maybe I'm mistaken, but I think it was about 1860 when first time photography appeared. So I can't have any photographies, but I've got these beautiful paintings. They are from 1813 till 1820, what I found. And they are a painting of young men, so they are kind of callers. And I'm keeping them in this small bag. which I saw in one of those prints that they was for small notes. So I took it for my pictures. Here in this pocket, I've got kind of mini booklets with notes or with some important things I think I would love to keep. And inspired by Bridgerton, I add there roses. Even in my usual journals, you will don't see so many flowers. In this one, I took those roses as a decoration, because if you haven't seen that Bridgerton series, go to have a look, really. I wasn't big fan of Regency era that much. I do like that era just because of Jane Austen, but not that much. After seeing that Bridgerton, I'm totally in love. Here you can see printed by Whittingham and Rowland. That was in the London Printing Company. So I took their names, or that Whittingham name, and I made those booklets. So here I would like to keep something, you know, some notes and important things. And of course, because it's about London Stone, it have to be decorated nicely. And it's so full. Like this. And here is my journal. That journal is holding behind this belly band. So I'm gonna move this booklet and I'm gonna show you my journal. I hand painted that front cover with gold painting because I think it's just matching that style and that era. I put those rhinestones here in the spine, and this is the cover of my book. And this book is really totally different than my usual books. Usually I do many pockets in my books, in my journals, but this one, it's just for writing. Here, just decoration, I add this beautiful stones or rhinestones. And here I've got bee charm. And it's very important in that series. You will see bee few times. And it's kind of because of the story of that family. So in this journal, which is very rare for me, are mostly just writing pages. I did few kind of sliding pockets using extra pictures. Here is a map of Bath when Henrietta, sister of Daphne, went for some... No, Francesca went there. Francesca went to Bath. So I've got picture from Bath and map of the city of Bath. And then just journaling pages. And I try to do very soft design for this journal, really soft design. Because that series is just so soft, so amazing. And another letter, I'm not gonna open them. And also, as a lady, I would love to have some fashion, you know. So I've got in this book two booklets like this, which can be like, you know, from a modist, from dressmaker, so I can choose which dress I would like to have, and my dressmaker will make it for me. And then again, writing pages. There is really a lot of writing space. I've got here another, it's like one from of those magazines, and this is from Goddess Ladies book, and it's fully readable. You can read those gossips, those columns. I've got here invitation to the ball, and of course it should be decorated because it's for London Stone. And from the other side there is note pocket. I've got here also, this is like a course, the order of course, what will be for the, you know, on the, what will be on the table. Poof. And writing pages. So as you can see, if you know my style, you can see that already now, that it's totally, totally different, that it's no pockets. I've got here a few bookmarks. One of these bookmarks is this with that bee seal stamp. So this is kind of very, very different than my usual style, but I can say that I really love it to create book like this, because it was after many months with pockets, pockets, pockets everywhere, I've got fully writing a journal. Here we've got another invitation to the ball, just picture of the Bath, of that city of Bath, and another printer. It's like business card, mini business card, and I forgot to show you the first episode of that Bridgerton series. It starts with first season ball. It's in House of Lady Danbury. She is, by the way, my favorite of all of these amazing actors. She is my favorite. She is awesome. I love her so much. She's really, really awesome. I wish to be like her, like, you know, to say things, do right things in the right time. So... invitation to her balls, to her ball looks kind of like this, so I tried to recreate it, not exactly, but inspired by that. So I've got here invitation, including the pencil, and ladies had it here while they were dancing. So I tried to recreate it. So I've got this one, and there we've got writing pages, and this, when I made that my small research through the time in that history, I found in 1813 catalog, there was, it was about sewing and what ladies should get in their household, and there was a needle holder. It had pocket like this, and there was some kind of another pocket, and when you took one side, you've got here needles. So I took that inspiration from that needle holder, and I made my holder for beautiful images from that time, and also kind of business cards from that time. Like this. All pages are hand painted with gold paint. You can see that. I'm gonna lift it up, and hopefully you will be able to see the gold around those pages. So all pages are handmade, hand painted by gold. And we've got here also a mini music portfolio, because ladies should be skilled in playing some kind of instrument, music instrument. So we've got small music portfolio or folio. And then again, writing pages. Another letter with another printer company, and invitation to Junior's ball. And I think I don't have too much here. Here is another invitation to the ball. So if you haven't seen that series yet, and if you do like romantic stories, and if you do like happy ending, go to have a look. Because this is really beautifully done. It's for a long time I haven't seen something so gorgeous like this. I'm telling you, I start to watch it and I couldn't stop. And my first click on that Bridgerton was just, I'm gonna have a look. I wasn't even interested too much, but once I clicked, it was just took me to that to that story, and I stopped after second time when I watched that. Like literally, I watched that twice in the row. It was through the weekend, and it was just wow. There was really wow effect. It's so beautifully done. They did amazing job, and I hope they will do another season, because the books of Juliet Quinn are awesome, awesome, very gorgeous. I think she won some award for writers. I do believe she won that with that Bridgerton, actually. So another folio or portfolio with the dresses, and we are nearly on the end. Here we've got another readable readable magazine magazine page. And we are nearly on the end, just for authenticity, I add there, these are from proper ledger book. It's not from the year 1830, this is from 1930. But anyway, look at that writing, it's so gorgeous, so I just added there. Just, you know, because I wanted to have there something proper, like really vintage, so that is just my other thing. And here we've got another, this is from printed by Charles Whittingham. It's just adding there that he was proper publisher. So this is my book inspired by Bridgerton. Beautiful, beautiful masterpiece. I'm so happy they did something like this. We need happy endings now. And this is my creation inspired by this gorgeous thing. Thank you so much for visiting me today. I hope you did enjoy my flip through to my totally writing journal. Thank you so much for spending your time with me today. And I hope I will see you soon. Bye. All links will be down below. Bye.